नमो वाणि भगवत् पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं वाजरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तं पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। यो ब्रह्मांड विदाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुमः देवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपच्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्री सिद्धगणेश नमो मीम सुख नित्यम सब प्रकाशम व्यापक नाम रूप अधिष्ठान बुद्ध बोध्यम बुद्धे तृक्यत्म पारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Okay, so we saw the Tippan also. The 282nd hour, so you are looking at Ishwariya Panchakoshaihi Tatswarupachhadanam. We looked at the Tippana, which mentioned that the Ishwara Koshas, although they hide the Swarupa of Ishwara, the veiling is only for the Jiva, not for Ishwara. सो यथा जीवस्य पंचकोशा जीवस्य यथार्थ स्वरूपं साक्षिणं आवृण्वन्ति तथैव तथेश्वरस्य समष्टि पंचकोशा ईश्वरस्य यथार्थ स्वरूपं आवृण्वन्ति बट फॉर हुम फॉर जीव तथा हि ईश्वरस्य यथार्थं स्वरूपं तत्पद लक्ष्यं यद्रूपं तदेव व्हाट इज यथार्थ स्वरूप यथार्थ स्वरूप इज लक्ष्यार्थ नॉट वाच्यार्थ वाच्यार्थ इज सगुण ब्रह्म लक्ष्यार्थ इज शुद्ध चैतन्य सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म तमेतम श्रौतमर्थम विहाय केचन माया रूपानंदमय कोश विशिष्टम अंतर्यामिनम तत्पद वाच्यमेव परम तत्त्वम् इति वदन्ति। When someone analyzes the तत्त्वमसि महावाक्य, there are some who say that as it is, there is Ishwara mentioned by तत्पदार्थ, therefore no further analysis is needed. That तत्पद वाच्यार्थ is the lakshya, is not the laksharta, is the lakshya for moksha for any jiva. So the jiva has to attain that saguna brahma, that is moksha. This is their interpretation. So maya rupa anandamaya kosha vishishta antaryami, antaryami Ishwara is an antaryami in each and every jiva, actually in the form of the jiva, but then these people misinterpret as antaryami is one who is there with the jiva, like the Mundaka Upanishad says there are two birds, one is a bhokta jiva, whereas the other is the Ishwara who watches over, karma phaladata who watches over, and that Ishwara is the goal for moksha. Therefore tam etam shrautam artham vihaya, giving up the real meaning of the shruti, which is तात्पर्य बीइंग इन लक्ष्यार्थ, द इक्वेशन इज इन द लक्ष्यार्थ, इक्वेशन रादर लीड्स टू द लक्ष्यार्थ ऑन बोथ साइड्स, वेयर बाय शुद्ध चैतन्य इज वन, दैट इज बीइंग सेड बाय द श्रुति, दैट श्रौतम अर्थम विहाय, गिविंग अप दैट श्रुति मीनिंग, केचन माया रूप आनंदमय कोश विशिष्ट विशिष्टम अंतर्यामिनम तत्पद वाच्यमेव, which is tatpada vachyartha, they hold on to that, they don't move to the implied meaning, and then parama tattvam iti vadanti. Now at tatpada vachyartha, there is no equation which is not solved, meaning as it is you cannot equate. LHS equal to RHS has to be solved if it is complex, you need to apply many steps to understand in mathematics. Similarly, here also you have to understand the complexity of Ishvara on one side and Jiva on the other side. Then the equation will become valid through implied meaning. As it is, if you look at it, it is mind-boggling. Ishvara, Sarvajna Ishvara, Nirankara Ishvara, Sarva Shaktiman Ishvara cannot be this Alpa Shaktiman Jiva, Alpajna Jiva, Sahankara Jiva. At all levels, there is Bheda. So on the face value, there is Bheda through and through. There is hardly an aspect which you can say it is same in Jiva and Ishvara. Of course, Shuddha Chaitanya, if you look at, being Satchid Ananda, that Tattva is common across Jiva and Ishvara, which is the Tatparya. But if you take the Tatpada Vachya Artha, the others Kechana, Tatpada Vachya Meva Parama Tattva, if they consider this Vachya Artha as Ishvara, Jagatkarta, where Tattvamasi Mahavakya occurs in Chandogya Upanishad, there Sat Brahma is discussed. Brahma is discussed in the Sat aspect. Then in the 7th and the 8th chapters, we see Ananda and Chid aspect also. But Sat aspect is described elaborately as being the Karana for the Prapancha in the 6th chapter of Chandogya Upanishad. Now, if this Sat Brahma, which is Ishvara, manifests as the Karta, Jagat Karta, that kind of Ishvara cannot be equated to the Jiva, because Jiva is not Jagat Karta. Any Jiva you ask, are you the Jagat Karta? The answer is obvious, no, I am not the Jagat Karta. And the question should be in the form of, you, the man or a woman, son or daughter of this such and such person, who has such and such person as a wife, such and such, you know, kids as children, that kind of an entity, that kind of a jiva, is that kind of a you, Jagat Karta? The answer is obviously no. So Tatpada Vachyam, if you take as Paramatattva, then on the flip side, on the other side, you have Jiva, which cannot be equated. So what do you have to do then? If you have already concluded, you as in the philosopher, one who has made a particular darshana or following a made darshana, concludes that Tatpada Vachyartha is the Paramatattva, then the equation not being possible, some other bogus ideas have to be brought up and call it a philosophy. So you'll have to interpret this. Tatpada, if you have taken, then Tat Tvam Asi, then what you have to do? Tattvam Asi will be misinterpreted as a samasa, not as an equation. Tattvam Asi, you are the Tattva. What is that you are the Tattva? Tasya Tvam Asi. So there are some samasas made. Tasmin Tvam Asi, Tattvam Asi, Tena Tvam Asi. All these are bogus ideas which are created. Anyway, Vyakaranavise, maybe let's say you assume that it is possible. Or other way of interpretation is, then you'll use Eng of Padantadati and say Atattvam Asi. Because, hey Shweta Keto, Shweta Keto Tattvam Asi, Okara is preceding Tat. So then Vyakaranava is again, Padachheda is possible, Atattvam Asi. But look at this mantra, not as an individual floating mantra where you can do any kind of mimamsa, use Vyakarana and destroy the entire Upanishad Tatparya. It has to fit in place. What was the question raised there? In the Upakrama and Upasamhara and whatever goes in between has to fit the context. Ekena jnanena sarvam jnatam bhavati. Yasya jnanena. Yasya kasya api. At least that tattva should be talked about, which is the proposition made. Pratijna has been made by which jnana everything is as well known. So if you know that you are not that Ishvara, which you already know, Nobody claims to be Ishvara. Everybody is born as non-Ishvara. It is a blasphemy to think that I am Ishvara. That kind of a Shweta Ketu is being taught that you are not Ishvara. So Prapta Seva Nisheda, it is not Prapta at all. Nobody claimed that I am Ishvara. Why will there be a statement in the Shruti saying that you are not Ishvara? Has absolutely no value. Shruti is not a pramana there. Even if Shruti were to say that Atattvamasi, you are not Ishvara, it has no pramanya because Shruti is not telling me anything new that I didn't know. And it does not fit the context because after knowing that I am not Ishvara, let's hypothetically assume that Shruti is telling me I am not Ishvara. Even if I understood something which I already knew and maybe in more details, yes, now Shruti has validated it that I knew it right from the very beginning that I am not Ishvara. Let's say Shruti has enforced that understanding. What do I get out of it? Do I get all jnana? No. It's completely out of context. So it is so out of tarka also. Using tarka, they try to establish that dvaita is the tatparya. Whereby it does not fit the context, it has absolutely no flow. What the teacher is claiming that did you, Shweta Ketu, ask your guru as to that jnana when known, that vastu when known, everything becomes known. Did you get that jnana at all? He says no. And at the end of the teaching, he says, you teach me now. And then the father, who is the guru, teaches Shweta Ketu, and as per these darshanas, their claim is what? Atattvamasi, you are not that. 9 times he had to be told that you are not that, and what did he get? Finally, he didn't get that knowledge. So the father has also, so they have tainted the guru and the Shruti also as having made the pratijna. It has not met. So it is just like children's story. There is nothing more to it. What do you get out of it? Nothing. Shweta Ketu got nothing. He just got a got an insulting set of, you know, statements from the father who insulted that you know next to nothing and then taught nothing. So it does not fit the context. It is completely out of the context and it is clearly based on preconceived notions. So that is what is indicated by saying tametam shrotam artham vihaya. What is the Shruti's tatparya if you look at it? Is to reveal something that you did not know. Jnanena moksha. So these who make such claims, they should even rethink that whether they should call themselves as Vedantins, because Vedanam antaha is Vedanta. And what is antaha? Nishchayaha. Vedanam antaha nishchayaha is Vedanta. They call themselves as following Vedanta, but where is the following of Vedanta? Shrotam artham vihaya. Kechana maya rupa anandamaya kosha vishishtam antaryaminam. Because this Ishvara is called as antaryami, who is abhimani of samashti sushuptav. Samashti sushupti avastha abhimani is Ishvara, called as antaryami Mandukya Upanishad. So Ishvara also has the kosha. Kosha sambandha is there. Maya sambandha is there. That also has to be dropped. Then only you will get the tatpada lakshartha, because vachyartha does not make sense. You need not supply words to conclude something which is not the tatparya. If you look at the tatparya of the same one Upanishad and compare across Upanishads, you should land on the same meaning. To do that, lakshana has to be used, not adding words, not misinterpreting or not breaking or using the Vyakrana rules as it is, but finding some meaning which does not fit the context in that very Upanishad and across Upanishads is not comparable at all. Also, Pramanya Buddhi is lost in the Shastra because what is unknown should be revealed. Then alone it is a Pramana. The eyes, if they let me understand what I am hearing, then eyes are not the pramana there. Eyes are pramana for rupa. This rupa cannot be known by any other sense organ. Therefore, drishti, that chakshur are pramana for rupa because rupa cannot be known by anything other than chakshu. Similarly, this jnana that I am getting from shruti, for that shruti will become the pramana only when it is revealing something that I cannot know through any other pramana. Then only it is a pramana. If it is telling me something which I already know, then it is anuvada matra. It is just a restatement, has absolutely no value of pramana. Pramanya value it does not have. Therefore, tatpada vachyam eva paramatattvam kechana iti vadanti kechana tatha eva anya hiranyagarbha vaishvanara vishnu brahma shiva ganesha devi suryadishu khadaga kuddalashvattha arka venvanteshu padartheshu paramatmatva bhrantim apannaha. Now he groups together everyone. Everyone who thinks that the Saguna Brahma is the Paramatattva, they are all wrong. So whether they be Hiranyagarbha Upasakas or consider Vaishvanara as the Paramatattva, Vishnu, Brahma, Shiva, Ganesha, Devi, Surya, Adipadena, whatever form you can think of, and then the, you know, the lower deities also. Like there are some deities mentioned there. We may not even have ideas of who these are. So Khadaga Kuddala, Ashwattha, Arka, Venu, Anteshu. So beginning with these at the highest level, and then local deities also included, they are not the Paramatattva. They are manifestation of the Paramatattva, all right, but they are not Paramatattva. So if they consider any of these, whether Hiranyagarbha on one side or Venu on the other side, whoever these deities are, any deity with form, if one considers as Paramatattva, then they have paramatmatva bhranti. They have attained apannaha. They are ones who have attained paramatmatva bhranti. Dvitiya tatpurusha. So paramatma tattvam bhrantim apannaha. It is not a compound anyway. It's a vyastapada itself. So apanna, they are. So it's but kartarikta here. So I wanted to say kartarikta. So they are ones who are apannaha. Kim apannaha? Paramatmatva, not paramatmatvam apannaha, but paramatmatattva bhranti apannaha. Paramatmatva bhranti apannaha. They are deluded regarding paramatma vishaya. Yadyapi sakala padarteshu lakshabhagaha paramatmanaha na bhinnaha. Tathapi tattad upadhi vishishtanyeva paramatmatvena manyante. Why are they wrong? Why are they deluded? Because although lakshabhaga, padarthishu lakshabhaga, paramatmanaha na bhinna. If you land on lakshartha, that lakshartha itself has manifested as the saguna brahma also. Sachidananda brahma has not become Ishvara by undergoing any change. Vivarta, vivarta karana. Maya makes this Sachidananda Brahma appear as Jagat Karta, because Jagat is apparent. Kartrutva is attributed to that entity which can undergo change. Nirguna Brahma cannot undergo change. Nirvikari. Avikari. So, Maya is brought in, and Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, Maya Vishishta Nirguna Brahma becomes Saguna now. Thereby becomes a Karta. That Jagat Karta Ishvara is not different from the Sachidananda Brahma. Tathapi Tattad Upati Vishishtaneva. When you look at these Hiranyagarbha, Vaishvanara, Vishnu, Brahma, those particular forms are Upadis. Therefore, tattad upadhi vishishtan eva paramatmatvena manyante. They don't consider that this Sachidananda Brahma is manifest in this rupa. They consider that that is the rupa itself is the final goal of jiva to understand and reach, that is moksha. Therefore, there is gati involved to attain that particular rupa, proximity to that rupa, becoming an ansha of that rupa, sharing the same loka as that rupa, or any other interpretation which has some morphing involved, some change, some travel involved, where upadhi is retained without knowing that it is an upadhi, thereby missing the goal. So what is it finally, if you look at it, is anandamaya kosha at best, not the kosha raita shuddha brahma shuddha chaitanya. Tadetat matam tesham bhrantireva. So etat matam, tadetat matam, this mata of whatever they have concluded, whichever deity they have concluded as a final paramatma tattva, that is their bhranti. Panchakoshavrutta jiveshwarayoho paramatma swarupat bahirmukhaha dehadishu atmatva bhrantim apadya punyapapani acharanti. So they are still stuck in the karmakanda, be it through upasana, but still stuck in karmakanda. Panchakosha vrtat jiveshwarayoho, because there is avarana of one or more of the panchakoshas, therefore jiveshwarayoho paramartha swarupa swarupad bahirmukhaha te. So they are bahirmukha. Paramartha swarupa is jiveshwarayoho paramartha swarupa is one. Tasmat paramartha swarupat bahirmukhaha. They are focused outward from the inward pratyagatma, which is not different from Ishvara. That Satchidananda tattva they are moved away from, focusing outward. Dehadishu atmatva bhranti mapadya. Thereby, they get deluded with this jiva. Who is this jiva? Jiva is, I am that jiva who has sharira. This is what Daitin say. If you ask them, who is the jiva? Because the jiva says, I am brahmana, kshatriya, ityadi. Therefore, that kshatriyatvam, brahmanatvam is in the jiva. In fact, this interpretation is so gross, at a grosser level, that the karma, theory of karma is compromised. If the jiva is one who is a brahmana right now in this janma, or kshatriya or vaishya or shudra, or a man or a woman, will that jiva continue to be the same in the next janma? So it is opposed to Puranas also. Cannot be so. The jiva's linga and varna will change. Why jiva's varna and linga? The prani bhava also will change. Manushyatvam va, pashutvam va. It is all changing across janmas. Otherwise, it defeats the purpose entirely of karmakanda also. So, jehadishu atmatva bhranti mapadya punya papani acharanti. They consider that at least in this janma, I am this deha sahita jiva. If it is deha sahita jiva, then jiva is not having samsara at all, because who is transmigrating does not have sharira. And in this janma, you associated yourself with the sharira. Nonetheless, punya and papa is their main primary focus, because that is the primary means. Antaryamyadi vamsha paryantanam padarthanam ishvara buddhya aradhanam krutva sukham praptum icchanti. Finally, their goal is sukha, just like every jiva's goal is sukha. But still, sukha is through what? Aradhana. Aradhana with padarthanam ishvara buddhya. Looking at these padarthas which are mentioned, all of these, whether the hiranyagarbha padartha padasya artha, hiranyagarbha, or Vaishwanara iti padasya artha, unto those padarthas they have Ishvara buddhi. And that Ishvara buddhi being there, with only that particular form, they want to understand that Ishvara and reach that Ishvara. That is their sadhana through aradhana. That is their goal through aradhana. So, padarthanam Ishvara buddhya aradhanam krutva. Whether it is antaryami or whatever is antaryamyadi, vamsha pariyantaram, all those which are mentioned there, and even something which is left out, adipadena included, whether some other new cult comes in, that is also included. So, other religions are also included really. In all these, padarthanam Ishvara buddhya aradhanam krutva sukham praptum icchanti. But the sukha that they get is not the swarupananda. They will get limited sukha because it will be anitya. Even if they think that this is sufficient for me, it will be anitya. They will be born again and again. Yadrisham upadim aradayanti tadanusarena phalancha siddhyati. So based on their following, whichever deity they follow, they will get that kind of a phala. Yasmat karana, because the upadhi is limited in many aspects. In some aspects, the upadhi has shaktis, has powers. So those are the things that the upadhi sahita brahma can grant. Ishvara manifests in a particular form, limited by the possibilities that the forms can bring in. What is possible through a particular form is possible only through that particular form. Need not be necessarily only, but then it cannot transgress the powers given. So it's like, you know, somebody, an office bearer, has some powers, cannot transgress that power, has limitations. So these bhaktas or whoever, these who do aradhana of that deity, will get limited phala because the deity's powers are limited. That deity can try the level best but still grant you only so much. It is not ananta. The sukha is not ananta sukha, and it is not nitya also, because the deity seen as Ishvara in that particular form only, misunderstanding that the Rupa is the Paramatattva, that Rupa Sahita deity itself that is not Nitya, does not have Ananta Sukha by itself, then where will the deity grant you from? Grant you Anitya, can grant you Nitya or Ananta Sukha? Deity doesn't have it, cannot give it to you. This is lost on them, because even if you focus on the Ishta Devata, but still look at that Ishta Devata as Satchidananda Brahma. That Ishvara who has taken that form, only that form, you like that form, which is fine. But still, the underlying Chaitanya should be seen as being all pervasive, manifest there in one form that I like, which is fine. But then seeing that form as a Paramatattva, beyond which there is nothing, that will limit the Ishvara in that deity's form, and thereby phala also, which will accrue to the sadhaka. Yasmat karana sukshma stula rupaha sarva api prapanchaha Ishvara sharire antarbhutaha tasmat tattad upasana anusari phalam bhavati. So the entire prapancha is Ishvara sharira. And therefore, you look at particular aspects of the prapancha as the body of Ishvara in a particular rupa, thereby the upasana will lead to particular phala. In keeping with the upasana, in keeping with the upasya also. Tathacha uktam panchadashyam chitradipe. And that is mentioned in the panchadashi also by Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya. Evamanye swasva pakshabhimanena anyatha anyatha mantrartha vada kalpadin ashritya pratipedire. Antaryaminam arabhya. Sorry, just give me one moment. Sorry. Antaryaminam arabhya stavaranteshvadina. Stavaranta ishavadina. So, stavaranteshvadina. Santyashvattharka vamshadehe kuladevatva darshanat. So, kuladevatas or the local deities at on one end and antaryami on the other end, Ishwar, antaryami Ishwara. So all these they consider in Kechana. Some are attracted towards a particular deity or somehow understanding of particular deity. Kula Devata is the end goal. So based on those misunderstanding, there is a swaswa paksha abhimanina. There is abhimana in swaswa paksha, their own paksha. This is the Lord, Devi, or be it whoever, Vishnu, Shiva, anyatha anyatha pratipedire. They understand differently. They understood differently. This is how the sampradayas have got, various kula sampradayas are there. And the mantra arthavada kalpana, all these arthavada also they take as literal and consider it, this is it. And then they stick to their own purana or their own deity described in any grantha, and that becomes the highest grantha. They follow that, everything else is bogus for them. Ityadina, there are so many verses in Panchadashi that describes this. Parantu mokshana brahmajnanam vina siddhyati. Brahmajnanam vina moksha na siddhyati. Moksha is impossible without brahmajnana, and they have known Brahma in a particular form, saguna Brahma. That jnana will not give aikya jnana, as we saw earlier. Therefore, it will not lead to moksha. So, yaha moksham icchati sa vivekena jiveshwarayo swarupam panchakoshebhya pratakritya janiyat. So what should one do who is a mumukshu? One who desires moksha should have viveka in this as well. So jiveshwarayo swarupam panchakoshebhya pratakritya vivekena. One has to discriminate oneself as separate from the deha. And then pratakritya janiyat. This is my swarupa. I am panchakosha rahita, shariratraya rahita, sachidananda brahma, which is same as tatpada lakshartha. Where this Ishwara or Ishtadevata, whoever I consider as Ishwara, has five koshas as well. So I have to understand the panchakosha viveka on the samashti level also. And thereby panchakosha rahita Ishwara is also Shariratraya Rahita, who is called as Sachidananda Brahma by the Shastra, which is my own Swarupa. Tatra Drishtanta, what is Drishtanta there? Yatha Militayoho Muncheshikayoho Pratakkaranam Kriyate Tatha Vivekena Jiveshwarayo Swarupam Panchakoshebhya Pratakritya Janiyat. So the Viveka is possible only through a sharp intellect. An example given is the Muncheshika. Muncheshika is a particular blade of grass which is used for puja ityadi. So it has a sharp edge. The stem is useful within it. So you have to be very careful in separating the stem from the blade of grass. Otherwise, if you know, you'll have cuts from the sharp edge of the grass. So that is mentioned here. Let's quickly look at that. Munja nama kosha vishishta jirga truna vishesha. So there is a long grass, particular type of grass. Ishika nama chatruna madhyastha kanda vishesha. So within there is some stem that is called as ishika. So from munja, ishika has to be separated out. Similarly, from this mixed jiva with a sharira, Sharira and Shariratraya or Panchakosha, same thing. So from Panchakoshas, the Atma has to be separated, the way we saw earlier, elaborately. Tatha Vivekena Jiveshwara Swarupam Panchakoshe Pratakritya Janiyat. Janiyat means what? You have to know that Atma as what? Sachidananda Brahma, which is same as Tatpada Lakshyartha. Panchakosha Viveka Prakara. So how it should be done? Janiyat, how so? So details are given here. Swapnavasthayam Stula Deho Na Bhati Parantu Atma Bhasate. तथा सुषुप्तौ सूक्ष्म शरीरस्य ज्ञानं न भवति सुखस्वरूप आत्मा स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूपेण प्रतीयते. सो अवस्था त्रय विवेक इज ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड हियर. इन द स्वप्नावस्था स्थूल देह अभिमान इज लॉस्ट. इन द जागृत अवस्था देयर इज स्थूल देह अभिमान. In the Swapna Avastha, although there is no Stula Deha, a Stula Deha is imagined and the dreamer has a Stula Deha as well, which is different from the Stula Deha of the waker. So there is no Stula Deha Abhimana. So Stula Deha, which is lying down in the bed, Na Bhati. You see that the Stula Deha, which you have, is moving around in the dream. Thereby, the dreamer's Stula Deha is different from the waker's Stula Deha, and this Stula Deha imagined in the dream cannot be called as a Stula Deha really. Therefore, Stula Deha Na Bhati. Stula Deha has the meaning of the Jiva, who is the waker, Jagrat Avastha, where he does sadhana. So that Stula Deha, which is lying down, resting, is not associated with, is not known to the dreamer, so in the Swapna Avastha. Parantu Atma Bhasate, but Atma, I am still the same. The dreamer has this Aham Bhava, which was there in waking state also, that continues. So there is Anuvritti of Atma across states, whereas Stula Deha does not have Anuvritti across states. Tatha Shushuptau Sukshma Sharirasya Jnanam Na Bhavati. And if you continue this, Viveka, Avastha Traya Viveka, you know that in the, just like the waker's body is not there in the dream, similarly the dream body, Sukshma Sharira, where the Sukshma Sharira is still there, that body, dream body as well as the Sukshma Sharira, which is actually dream body, whether Stula or Sukshma, is Sukshma Sharira itself. That is not there in Sushupti also. So, Tadapi Na Bhati, Sukshma Shariram, Jnanam Na Bhavati, Tasya Jnanam Na Bhavati, means Na Bhati. Same idea as earlier, but with the Sukshma Sharira. So, Stula Sharira and Sukshma Sharira have Vyabhichara across Avasthas, whereas Atma, Swaswarupa Atma, Sukhaswarupa Atma has continuity, has Anuvritti in each of the states. I know that I existed the same way in waking, dream and deep sleep. So, Sukhaswarupa Atma, Swayam Prakasha Swarupena Pratiyate. Self-shining nature is the Atma. Atma has self-shining nature, known to oneself by oneself without any intermediary. I know I exist. I don't need anyone or anything to tell me that I exist. I know by myself. Even if someone tells me you do not exist, I would consider the person has gone bonkers, but I won't think that I do not exist because someone tells me. Same with my consciousness. My chitta is known to me without any intermediary, without anything or anyone. I know that I am conscious. No one can tell me otherwise. So too with Sukha also. If someone tells me, no, you are having Dukkha, my Sukha is known to me. If someone tells me you are yelling in your deep sleep, that time I may be dreaming and I may have seen a night where I am yelling, but then in deep sleep, I had Sukha Anubhava, which is my Swarupa Sukha. No one can tell me otherwise. No, in deep sleep, you have a lot of dukkha. If that is true, nobody will desire to go to sleep. Everyone desires to sleep. That is why snoozing the alarm, you know, and getting late for every activity, getting up late, is because there is sukha in Shushupti Avastha. So, Sukhaswarupa Atma Swayam Prakasha Swarupena Pratiyate Shushuptau Sukhajnana Bhave Sukamaham Aswapsam Iti Smritihi Suktotitasya Nasyat. If there is still an argument that no, there is no Sukha, Satta and Chitta I understand, but Anandatvam I don't understand. Ananda Swarupa is questionable. If that is true, then I won't say that I slept blissfully. I need not say I know. That expression in my mind, oh, I had an amazing sleep. Even it is for, you know, sometimes a person is so tired that there is only a 5 minute, just 5 minutes, you know, these days they have this called as, you know, power naps. Afternoon you take 5-10 minutes break, take a power nap, recharge yourself, re-energize. It is coming from your Atma, which recharges the body. The body merges with the Atma. That's where it gets all its charge from. It is not just resting. You cannot rest your body without going to deep sleep completely. You cannot remain active, whether in waking state or dream state. Your mind being active is not sleep. That's why people who slept throughout the night also and didn't get a good sleep, they'll say that, no, I had a disturbed sleep. What is that disturbed sleep? It is not moving around on the bed. You are still lying down. What is the disturbance? Even if you lie in that supine position flat throughout the night, still the disturbed sleep is the mind running haywire. So mind being active is not going to relax you at all. So the relaxation is when you are in your own Swarupa. That is why it is, in Ayurveda also, it is called as, one is Arogya. The other is your Swarupa Avastha. Going back to that, that's why in English also, dis-ease. Disease is what? Not being at ease. That is disease. So, Swaswarupa Avasthanam. So, that's the Sushupti is the basis to know my Ananda Swarupa. So, Sukham Aham Aswapsam Iti Smriti Sukto Titasya Nasyat. Tatha Smritehe Jayamanatvad Eva Sushupto Sukhanubhava Abhyupeya. So, you have to infer that. You have to infer that any which way you will know that in Sushupti, without any Vishaya, without any Kosha Sambandha, I had Ananda. So, Swayam Prakasha Swarupena Ananda Api Pratiyate. Swayam Prakasha Rupa. It is, Ananda is also not known through any Vishaya. It is manifest in the Vishaya. Through any Karana also, Antakarana also manifest this Ananda. But it is not the Swarupa Sukha. Swarupa Sukha is known as Swayam Prakasha Swarupena. Ananda Api Pratiyate Sushupta Vavastham. It is gathered on waking up, and if you use some Anumana, you will land on it. Tachya Sukham Sushupta Na Vishaya Janyam. Sorry, I was a little lost in that. I said Ayurveda. So that I meant to say Swasthyam. So what is Swasthyam? Swasthyam is Swastha. Swastha bhava is swastyam. And swastha is what? Swasmin tishtati iti swastha. So swastyam is being in one's own swarupa. In Ayurveda also, moksha is the goal, which is the sharira is the final disease. Not this sharira. After solving all the problems of stula and sukshma shariras, then Ayurveda says that you have to, the goal, maintaining the stula sharira and sukshma sharira well, final goal is swasthyam, which is going across the karana sharira also. Resolving this karana sharira dosha, what that karana sharira itself is a dosha. Janma itself is a dosha. That itself is a disease. So how do you finally cure yourself? Swasmin tishtati. One remains in one's own swarupa. Yoga Shastra is no different. Finally, goal of all Shastras is Nitya Moksha. That's why when debating also, Bhagavan Bhashyakara would say, if you interpret it this way, there is Shruti Virodha, and if you say there also you can't see Shruti Virodha, you will land on Moksha, which is Anitya. Moksha, Anitya Moksha is no Moksha. If you are okay with it, it's okay, but don't call it moksha. It is loose usage of moksha word, the word moksha. It has to be nitya avastha. So finally, swastyam has to be that swarupa, swarupa avasthanam. Tada drishte swarupa avasthanam. In Yoga Shastra also, one has to land on the swarupa of the drashta also. Tada drashtu swarupa avasthanam. That in one's own swarupa is atma, in pratyagatma. That happens to be Sachidananda, Kosha Rahita. Sankhyas and Yogis also land on the same one. unfortunately, Aikya is not known. They don't agree with Aikya. Therefore, many Sachidanandas are there, which is Shruti Viruddha. Therefore, only Advaita talks about that Swarupavastha where nothing else exists. That Advaita Atma, Advaita Brahmatma, which is not different at any level because there is no other level there. There is no Samashti Vyashti Bheda left at all because whatever was creating Samashti Vyashti Bheda, that has gone. Panchakoshas, Shariratrayas, they are all gone, which is the goal of all Veda Vedanga. Tachcha Sukham Shushuptau Na Vishaya Janyam. And we know that in Shushupti there is no Vishaya, neither Jagrat Vishaya nor Swapna Vishaya. Therefore, Sukha, which is there in Shushupti, is not Vishaya Janya. Tada Sarvakarya Prapancha Pravilayat. Because Prapancha has completely resolved, all Karyas have resolved in that Atma. Therefore, in Shushupti there is no Vishaya, there is no Kriya, which is also for Sukha. In each avastha, there is a hunt going on for Sukha that is met in Shushupti avastha when you drop all pursuit, drop off all pursuits. Kintu tad atma swarupa sukham meva. That is one's own swarupa sukha. Such a atma, swayam prakasha swarupa. We have seen this. Tasma sukha swarupa atma, swayam prakasha rupena shushuptau bhasate. So, this sukha swarupa also is known by oneself to oneself in Shushupti Avastha very clearly and then gathered in waking. Nididhyasana phala bhuta nirvikalpaka samadhautu atma ajnana kruta avarna rahitaha prakashate. So in Shushupti Avastha, why is there no moksha? Because there is no possibility of jnana. It has to be known as my sukhaswarupa, my own sukhaswarupa, which is the samashti sukhaswarupa also. That is not known, but in Nididhyasana, Nididhyasana Phalabhuta Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. So Nididhyasana in its best should end in Nirvikalpaka Samadhi, where there are no Vikalpas, there are no Vritti Bhedas also. There is no effortful retention of Jnana. Jnana, when it takes place, it has to counter Ajnana so that no other effort is needed. And in that effortless Swarupavasthana, there will be no Vikalpas possible. That kind of a Nirvikalpa Samadhi being the resultant, that is the Phalabhuta. It is a resultant to Atma. In that state, Atma Ajnana Krita Avarna Rahitaha. It does not have Shushupti kind of Ajnana. Ajnana is there in Shushupti. In Nirvikalpa Samadhi, Ajnana Krita Avarna is not there. That Avarna goes away, thereby Swayam Prakashate Atma. However, Jnana lacking, it comes back again once the Samadhi is over. But if it is Nididhyasana Phalabhuta, not just Nirvikalpa Samadhi of a yogi, if it is Nididhyasana Phalarupa, then it is after Shravana and Manana, therefore Jnana being there, this is the Nishtha that Shruti talks about. So, Ajnana Krita Avarna Rahita Prakashati, then alone the Ajnana is gone, Avarna is completely gone. Karana Sharira Rupa Ajnana Mapi Tada Na Bhasate, then the Karana Sharira Ajnana, which itself is Ajnana, that is not going to veil and hide your Swarupa, just like it is there, it is hidden in Shushupti, has to be gathered in the waking state, but in this case, in Samadhi Avastha, there is no veiling of the Ajnana. Karana Sharira veil isn't there, thereby the Ananda is known, is without Avarna. That Ananda Supa is shines forth without Avarna. Ittham Dehatrayam Vyabhicharati Ekam Avastham Vihaya Avasthantare Abhanat. So if you look at any of the Shariras, all the Shariras do not have Anuvritti in other Avasthas. So this Stula Sharira isn't there in Swapna and Shushupti Avastha. Sukshma Sharira isn't there in Sushupti Avastha. It is there in Swapna alone. And Karana Sharira, although it is there in Sushupti Avastha, it is not there in Samadhi. So there is Vyabhichara of Dehatraya, but Atma is there in all the three Avasthas and in Samadhi also. Therefore, Tasma Dehatrayam Avyapakam. So Dehatrayam is Avyapakam and Anityancha. Dehatraya is not all pervasive across states and it is Anitya also. Atma tu Sarvavasthas Swanugataktaya Bhati. But by itself, in all avasthas, Atma shines forth, tasmad vyapakaha nityascha. Therefore, Atma is pervading all states and nitya also. Itham dehatraya vilakshanataya vivichya atmanam janiya. This is how one should know Atma separated from the dehatraya by analyzing the avasthas. So, we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next part. Huh? सुखम नित्यम सप्रकाशम व्यापकं नामरूप अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वेन अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परमः तदेवान्नमत्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः ॐ तत्सत्।